Hello and welcome guys, I'm DinXy and this is Amvebot TV with a let's play of Saviors. It's a game that was recently released on Steam by Sharp and Tight Studios. And if you check, it's their first game on Steam and what a debut this one is. It's pretty good, that's why we're gonna let's play it. Let's see, it's a casual shmup, not so casual once you start progressing. Huge tons of levels, like 18. Granted, they don't last that much, I mean 5 minutes? At the first, and then the later ones last way more, especially because the bosses get tougher. You can use keyboard or your controller. My controller gets detected, you can even rebind it. It's pretty good. As you can see, I'm using custom bindings. Then you can save, but sure you can rebind the keyboard as well. I haven't done it because I'm using gamepad for this. Let's check the in-game settings. I haven't enabled the vSync because the game actually has a limited for FPS, so that's actually better for me than the vSync. I don't care about that much, I just don't like games running with like 1000 FPS and setting my PC on fire. Okay, it's just some presets here for... oh, it's actually only 2 presets, oh well. The game uses like 3D models because there's some perspective switching. Probably we'll see that later on. And the most important part is that you can actually upload your replays and shit in Steam and people can actually go and check it out. Let's see if my replays, yep, still first. You can go and download it. You can see my mouse is still in game as well. Did that not on the first try, on the first area, was how powerful the B1 ship is. This is on, yeah, that was on survival. That was actually my first try trying survival, was it? Yeah, because I played the arcade version. Else, what kind of medals do I have here? Let's see. How much time did I play it? Yeah, on story I played with B1. Because it's a female character, who play the story now as well. I'm just showing you what the game has done. Oh, wait, what? Why do I have a gold star? And story mode. How can I reach power level 15? What? How many times I need to die to do that? Like, when I completed the story, I don't think I died. I think I died twice, because I was like, okay, first time on level 16, and I didn't play the... like, because the game saves your progress on story mode. So I just jumped straight back into the action, and it was like one of the last levels. I think the game has 18 levels, if you can check replays. Actually, there are pages. Those are mine, you can see. Yeah, those are all the stages. You can see your multiplier, that's actually how good you performed on the level. And then you can just spray, and then once the level starts, you can actually speed up. Oh yeah. And then you can slow down, back up, and then speed up, back. And the music is just awesome. There's the soundtrack with the game, but this is probably one of my best... yeah, well, the first time I played this, I reached like level 6. Was my previous... wait, was it my first record online, and then I was whistling this music at the end of the day. It's pretty good. Pretty much all the music is pretty good, but this epic boss music is my favorite, I think, by far. Let's see what else in the replay. Oh yeah, once you start the replay, you can actually switch between stages, like next stage, like one next stage, previous stage, stuff like that. What else is there to check? Online high scores? Yeah, you can check the score attack arcade. What? I'm not first? What? Oh yeah, I think, yeah, that was my first play. I reached level 6. Meh, bad shit. Oh well. I replace. I think it's time to start. Actually, there is the help way. Everything is explained, how you... what's the difference in the difficulties, because once you reach your max multiplier, you're starting to break people, and when you break one ship, the other one explodes close to it, and it's pretty much easier to reach in the other mode than in arcade, I think. Yeah, arcade is pretty different. I mean, it's pretty harder than the rest, that's why my high score on arcade is so bad. And there's the credits. Music, man. I don't think it's copyrighted yet, but if you don't hear any music, you should check it out somewhere else. I'm recording this with music and it's not copyrighted at the moment, but this may change. Okay, we'll just jump exit into the story mode. I'm wondering what's the practice. You can actually pick level. Wow. Okay, how the story mode works is you can pick whatever. Well, we play normal is the way to be played, the way I beat the game. So we'll go normal. Here we go. You can pick three noobs. There is some story, but come on, it's a shmup. I'm not gonna be focusing on it and gonna blatantly skip it. And I'm gonna pick the girl called Mona. Doesn't really matter what the ships look like. You can customize your ship before each level. Maybe not before the first one. Let's see. Oh yes, we can. Here we go. Oh, I can choose from the start. Holy shit. Oh, this is gonna be easier than I thought. Because I beat the game already? Nice. Oh, fuck it. I'm gonna try the multi-rocket then, since it's new. And then the perks. Okay, perks are reset at front weapon. Huh. I guess only the secondary weapon is unlocked once you beat each boss. Each boss unlocks. You start with the rocket, with those rockets. Maybe I should be starting with them to be authentic, but I mean, doesn't really matter, the first few levels are easy as shit anyway. I'm gonna be speak-ticking with my trusted, actually never played with a multi-rocket, but I'm gonna try it, side weapon. Yeah, okay, so, when probably for the first couple levels, it doesn't matter what starting character you pick. So I went with those slow moving shit, cause I can shoot, move, and then until the wave reaches the top of the screen, I'll be somewhere else already, and then the wave is gonna be clearing the enemies in the... Wow, it's hard to explain, you see, when I start playing. Basically talking nonsense at the moment. Let's go to the mission briefing, here we go. Alright, race, this is the moment you've been waiting for, blah blah blah. You can skip the text, you can start the mission. What's that really gonna do? Mission 1. So basically, I don't know, didn't read the story that much. But yeah, we're saving from invasion and then we go to their home world. Don't quote me on that, I'm not sure, but something like that, and then we kill everybody. And here comes the game! I don't think I've ever... I don't think I've ever encountered an obstacle that I can hit in game that wasn't a 3D object. So basically only enemies can be... I'm not even sure I can collide with them. Sometimes there are trees later on that's so big that showing through the screen, but... Oh my god, I forgot what I was talking about. Oh, there we go, now we're breaking shit, and then everything explodes. And then we can switch to the side. Yeah, you have freeze switch that you decide to just shoot on the side or shoot forward. But once you shoot to the side, yeah, the power of your shot gets split in three ways, so at least for your secondary shot. You have a first weapon, you see that on upgrades. And then you have secondary weapon, and then you have the bombs that you can see on the right. I have 32 left. They're pretty... There we go. Did I just miss with them? Not sure. I think I got... Yeah, not this time. I think I've got 100% on this level before. Because of the break, you can see the multiplier is so high, I'm breaking shit up. And I'm just flying left and right, that's why the waves are so good. So, there is not so many bullets in this game, but they're like aiming at you. So, moving left and right in one spot is pretty much the best tactic you'll die. Because the game tried to predict where you're gonna go, or, well, aim it at you. And you'll see me moving just on one spot as a pro player. Oh, this is getting... Why so hard all of a sudden? Didn't we play on normal? Maybe I'm just bad and not breaking shit here. Yeah, probably. There we go. Just a nice break. Here we go. Oh. What? I'm forgetting how this level worked. Obviously, you see those, they first show you on the screen as red, and then you know, okay, this is coming from there. That's important, because later on there are some levels where everything is speed up. You should get stuff. Well, the multiplayer could have been higher, probably I missed. Because I should not be talking while shooting, but oh well. There is no replay on the story mode, that would have been nice. Okay, so what we can choose now. Directional fighting, increase fire speed on the sides mode, not so good. Secondary weapon capacity and firing speed, yeah, that's like the biggest upgrade, that's why I'm taking it. 50% less multiplier while taking health damage. Yeah, first you have shield and then you start taking health damage while the shield slowly regenerates, and you can upgrade that the shield regenerates faster than shit. You'll see that here later on. Not every level gives you a perk. I think it's your level. I'm power level 2 at the moment. Yeah, your level gives you the perk points. You need overcharged, EMP upon. Yeah, that's not so bad. I'm gonna take it because of the later on upgrades. And overweight, I think I only put 1 points ever when I beat the game the first time. So yeah, reduce your fight speed. Well. Low durability by 25%. I don't know, you still die like 3 hits or something. Depends on the hits. Sometimes if you just collide with something that's pretty long, you take a lot of damage. Well. Okay, so here we go. We have energy waves and we have power shot. That's pretty bad. I like the spread. So we're sticking with that. And then side weapon, new. What could it be? Oh, those. Nah. There are quite a few weapons. I think, what, 8 front weapons? Or 6? And then the same amount of side weapons, and then the secondary weapons are like 6, okay. Probably 6, yeah. 6 or 18 weapons to combine. It's pretty good, and you can even change your difficulty mid-mission. Well, good enough. Okay, well, that was level 1 with a lot of overview of the game. I'm DinXy, thanks for watching, guys. This was Avibat TV with the Let's Play Saviors. See you next time. Don't forget to rate the video and follow the channel. Thank you.